We're going to get started here, and today is today's very important day. We have a great group of our friends of recovery, right? I'm Senator George Amador, one of the co-chairs of the Senate Task Force of Heroin and Opiate Addiction. I am alongside my other co-chairs, which is Senator Ashar and Senator Jacobs, and we are honored to be amongst our friends of recovery in the state of New York. We know that recovery is possible, and today we want to send that loud message, loud and clear, to the governor and to other members of the legislature that this is not about a one-time investment that was made last year with a $25 million addition to the budget. This is about investing in the journey of recovery, making sure we have affordability, accessibility, but also the services in every community around the state of New York so that our friends of recovery can continue to help those who battle and struggle with addiction in the state of New York. Right? Yeah. So we're going to continue to work hard, and with that, I want to introduce one of my colleagues and a co-chair of the task force, Senator Ashar.
Thank you. Well, it's good to be with everybody today. Thank you for being here. I'm going to be brief. I made a comment this morning that there's a time to listen and there's a time to act. It's high time to start acting. And the state has a role to play in all of this, right? I said that earlier. The state's role is to put their money where their mouth is. Is that right?
Yes. Yes.
We have a moral obligation to take care of those that are suffering from this deadly disease. It's our moral obligation. And I'm saying today, before we spend a single dollar building a gondola or putting colored lights on bridges in New York City, it's our moral obligation to take care of those that are suffering from addiction. That's my position. I could not be happier to serve on the Senate's Heroin Task Force with Senator Amador, and I am deeply honored to introduce Senator Chris Jacobs from Western New York.
Thank you very much. It's an honor to be here. It's an honor to be with all of you. Thank you for everything you do. Thank you for being here, your courage in being part of this fight. I'm truly humbled and honored to be appointed to co-chair this task force this year with these two men who have done so much work in the last several years, putting forth meaningful legislation, which I think has advanced this fight. But we have so much more farther to go and more to come to make sure that this is in the rearview mirror. I will work here diligently. I'm here today, as Senator Ashar said, to listen and learn. I have a lot to learn as a new member, both here in the Senate and as a co-chair. I come from Buffalo, New York, which, like every other area in New York State, has suffered so much by this tragic epidemic we have. We need the public sector, the private sector, the civil sector to be fully engaged in this to overcome this epidemic. I look forward to working with you to make sure this is the beginning of the end of this. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you, Senator Jacobs. And with that, we are also so glad and we're honored to be graced with the presence of Assemblywoman Rosenthal, who chairs Alcoholism, Substance Abuse in the Assembly, and a good partner on our efforts. Let's welcome.
Thank you for that wonderful welcome, and welcome to all of you to be here in Albany in these beautiful halls where we are demanding that we get enough funding to make sure everybody who wants treatment has access to treatment, people who are in recovery have support systems, and that we stop treating this epidemic as a criminal justice issue. This is a public health emergency. Now, I've heard heard stories from families that a loved one wanted treatment. They lived in an area where they might have to drive an hour to get help. During that time, if you don't have a car, forget it. You're not getting help. In that drive, who knows what happens? We need treatment on demand. When people are ready, we need to be ready for them. Now, New York State has been particularly hard hit with the opioid and heroin crisis. It's true across the country, people are suffering, but in New York State, more people are dying of this problem addiction. Now, I have no judgments of anyone. Everybody's on their own journey, everybody's on their own path, and we are here to support you, to see that there are enough peer counseling, clubhouses, resources for everyone who needs help along the way. And I will fight my hardest to make sure everyone gets that. Thank you.
Well, thank you, Assemblywoman. So with that, we do send this loud and clear message. And that message is recovery is possible. Yeah. And this is the face in the community of recovery. And any community that helps each other, any community that helps each other overcome the struggles, the bondage, the difficulties of life, is a community also that celebrates each other's successes and victories. And with that, these are the individuals, the faces of recovery, that we celebrate their victory of overcoming those days of dread and those days of difficulty, because they did overcome. Now let's carry the message that through with the services and through the journey of recovery, we can help others who need to get in recovery. So thank you all, and let's keep marching forward. We can win, right? We can win.